He took me out of the Skid Row home for boys when I was just a little tyke. He gave me a warm place to sleep under the counter. He gave me nice food to eat like meatloaf and water. Floors to sweep and toilets to clean and every other Sunday off.
You know, I think you ought to raise your expectations a little bit, Seymour. Now that we're successful, I mean. Well, why don't you sell us some new clothes? No offense, but with all the photo sessions and interviews, a big experimental botanical genius has to look the part.
I'm a very bad shot, Audrey. I don't have good taste like you.
Well, I can help you fix some things out.
You could?
Sure.
You'd go shopping with me?
Sure.
You'd be seen in a public place like a department store with me?
Sure.
Tonight?
Oh, I can't tonight. I've got a date. But I'd like to go with you some other time.
Sure, I'll pencil you in.
I bet you get a lot of dates now, huh?
Well, not dates exactly. A lot of brain clubs ask me to give lectures.
Gee.
Imagine me giving lectures. I didn't even finish grade school.
Well, that doesn't matter. You have life experience.
Some experience. I don't know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat at a fancy restaurant like Howard Johnson's.
Well, me neither.
Or ride a motorcycle.
Oh, it's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. Gee, I better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dollar.
No problem. Here you go.
It's right over there. But if you're like the hundreds of others flocking to see Audrey too, you better come back tomorrow, man, because this shop is closed today.
Ooh, check this out!
I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You ain't by chance talking about a girl with a black eye.
And several other medical problems?
As a matter of fact... I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I'd call